tama ba ang mga hakbang na ginawa ng ating gobyerno? Ang sagot po namin, opo.
Malacanang asserting the Duterte administration took the right steps in addressing the COVID-19 pandemic. Presidential spokesman Harry Roque also assures the public the government is in control of the health crisis in the country. He, however, admits there are things authorities could have done better.
Hindi po tayo perpekto, pero narito na po tayo. And one thing I can assure you, the president did the very best.
For opposition leader Vice President Leni Robredo, this is not the time to be complacent and repeat past mistakes. She calls on the Duterte administration to assess its COVID-19 response.
Hindi tayo dapat maging kontento na may tama tayong ginagawa kasi yung tama nating ginagawa, talagang matatabunan yun ng maling ginagawa kung hindi natin i-assess kung bakit tayo nagkakamali.
Senators also blame the government's delayed action to contain the deadly virus as COVID-19 cases in the country continue to rise. Data from the World Health Organization show the Philippines has added almost 10,000 new cases from June 14 to 28. That's the most number of new COVID-19 cases in the Western Pacific region in the last 2 weeks. For Senator Francis Pangilinan, the findings showed that the Philippines had the worst pandemic response. Senate President Vicente Soto III, for his part, says the Interagency Task Force on COVID-19 needs to address the health department's programs and protocols. President Duterte's former aide, Senator Bongo, meanwhile urges the government to improve its test, trace, and treat strategy. Malacanang, however, disputes the WHO report, saying it's not proper to compare Manila to Singapore. The health department, for its part, says the Philippines should not be compared to other countries without considering other factors, such as health system capacity and socioeconomic status. The agency notes Manila has been seeing more positive developments compared to its Southeast Asian neighbors.
Bagaman mas mataas ang ating case fatality rate na 3.55% kumpara sa kabuuang 2.9% para sa lahat ng bansa sa ASEAN, patuloy po ang pagbaba nito at mas mababa po ang ating case fatality rate kumpara po sa buong mundo na 5.15%.
COVID-19 cases in the Philippines climbs to over 36,000 as the country logs nearly 1,000 new infections Monday. Recoveries near 10,000, while the death toll stands at more than 1,200. Researchers from the University of the Philippines estimates the number of cases in the country will rise to more than 60,000 by end of July. At least 15,000 of that figure will come from Cebu, which is now the epicenter of the pandemic in the country.
Out of the almost 4,000 cases, about half are actually under home quarantine. So better to extract them out of the community to ensure safety of the families and also, of course, the neighborhood.
Security forces are deployed in the city, while a medical team composed of military doctors and nurses flew to the province over the weekend. Cebu City is now under the enhanced community quarantine. Prevailing community quarantine measures nationwide are set to expire on Tuesday, the same day President Duterte is expected to announce fresh virus restrictions.
We don't want to preempt yung pronouncement ni Presidente. Nakikita namin talaga kailangan pa ng stringent restrictions.
Meanwhile, the government has stopped the transport of locally stranded individuals from Metro Manila to provinces, citing the lack of quarantine facilities. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.